be joining them live from Glasgow any minute now. But first of all, here's their exclusive guided tour around their hometown.
My name's Billy Agle and I'm looking for a white wedding.
Hi, I'm Tommy. Hi, I'm Tommy. It's
Tommy. Hi, my name's Neil and I'm known as The Wiz.
My name's Graham Clark and I'm a college.
Hello, my name's Marty Pella. I'm the lead singer of the Scottish band Wet Wet Wet.
Hi, we're Wet 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 and this is our Glasgow.
Of our first gig, historic time for us. We supported a band called King. Where are they now?
Easy, Clarky.
But probably our mothers and fathers met here many years ago, so it's a kind of landmark. Being a Glaswegian, you know, it was always an ambition being in a band to play here. Okay, this was also the scene of our first televised interview, which was very nerve-wracking indeed. And
1985 it was, I think.
1985.
As you can see, that's a nice intimate rock and roll gig. It looks a lot smaller than we remember it being, but I guess when you're young and naive, a place that size can look like a stadium to you, but we come back and it seems really small. But it's one of the best gigs in Glasgow because of the atmosphere. Very unique.
You have played it again since?
Yeah.
Funnily enough.
The Barrowlands. Freak or unique?
The Barrowlands. Okay, we're in Paddy's Market, which was started in the 1820s by Irish immigrants. This is a flea market of Glasgow. This is where you can buy a dead man's suit for about £5. If you don't have much money, you can dress yourself. Stage gear, a speciality. And then we're going to try and we'll go for a wander through and let's see what happens.
Right.
Beautiful, beautiful. Here's a find. How about a nice green waistcoat? This would suit you.
A bit of EQ here.
Leave
it, Grader. Just fixing it out here.
Well, we came in here one new year on the 4th of January to record a track which we weren't really that familiar with called Love Is All Around for a movie we weren't familiar with at all called Four Winds and a Funeral.
What's that? 10:30 at Helensburgh.
And so basically we came in for 2 days and didn't really give it much thought, recorded a track and it went on to stay number one for 15 weeks. Is this the recording in this Tascam desk here?
Well, this is the gallery of modern art. Originally, it was the home of the Cunningham family, who were tea merchants. It was a family home, but then they gave it up and it went to the exchange people. At one point, it was the Royal Bank of Scotland. And then after that, it became the Stirling Library. And then in 1990, they closed it and it became this, the Gallery of Modern Art, which is very superb. We're in Glasgow, quite near the centre. But over there is Clydebank, the small town just out the edge of Glasgow where Wet 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 started.
It's a fishing village off the coast of the Clyde.
It is indeed, yeah. Small fishing village.
Way out west.
And behind that, we have the hills, Kilpatrick Hills. Countryside, beautiful, beautiful man. So we stay out that way, or grew up over that way. And Glasgow's kind of been reborn in the last say 10 years. It's about art, it's about design, it's about good restaurants, great clubs. And I guess number one is the fact that it actually has a heart. It's a big city with a village attitude, and that's Glasgow, and that's where we live, and why we stay here.
What's that, Tommy? What's this are you talking about?
Fantastic. They should certainly be working for the tourist board.
I think they should. And I love it. It's put that song on my brain again from Four Weddings and a Funeral, which was on everybody's brain. Do you remember when it was out?
Oh, yeah. Now, hopefully, we can join them in Glasgow with a bit of luck.
Oh,
hello
yes.
There.
Hello.
Hey, it's Marty and Tommy. Hiya.
How are you doing, guys?
Fine, fine.
First question.
Ready for our in-depth interview.
Well, Marty, it's going to be very in-depth because the first question is, talk me through your hair.
Well, I don't see what all the fuss is about. You know, a guy puts his hair back to its original colour and, you know.
Good response!
Here's me thinking I would be like the a silver fox like yourself there, Philip.
Yeah,
you know?
I know, yeah, absolutely. When I gave up in the end, because mine's not far off that colour, I have to say, although I...
Yeah, but the beard,
sure,
it's the two-tone, it's the...
But
well,
people
keep... The cuffs don't match, yes.
People kept coming up to me in supermarkets and saying, ah, you look like a badger.
A badger.
So I stopped in the end.
All right, badger, yeah. Okay. He's a badger.
So are you actually based in Glasgow?
Yeah, we still stay based in Glasgow. It seems to... it's an inspiring city for us, in as much as we can understand Glasgow, the working class background, so a lot of our songs, the ideas come from the place that's right behind us here, Glasgow,
yeah. And what about you, Marty?
Well, yeah, I still stay based in Scotland. Scotland won't get rid of me that easy.
Do you have houses elsewhere?
Oh yeah, all over the world, yeah.
Obviously, yeah.
Yeah, obviously, you know, London, Paris, Rome.
Have you been forced as a pop star to move out of Glasgow though? Obviously you've got to spend more time away, but what about living away?
Living away? We spend a lot of time travelling, to be honest. Probably 6 or 7 months of the year is spent on the road. So we get the chance to live these places, you know, we get to stay in Paris doing the work. And when the work finishes, we come home. So I think that's one of the reasons why we still stay in Glasgow, because when we come back, it kind of refreshes the batteries, recharges us up, gives us inspiration.
I also think after that film we've just seen, you might, when you come back and you're resting in between tour, you might get a job with the Scottish Tourist Board.
We were good, weren't we?
Yes, that's right. There's juice loose about this house.
That's my favourite. I love that. There's juice loose about this house. I can do a good guys. Is that a good accent?
Yeah.
When I first started doing the afternoons, now I did sort of Saturday mornings and then worked with Emma on Saturday mornings, we have seen so many bands come and go. And you guys have been there consistently right the way through.
What's the secret?
Why? What's happened?
It's obviously weight fluctuation and haircuts.
That must be what it is.
That's the secret. An occasional good song, obviously.
When you did Four Weddings and a Funeral, did you have any idea? Had you seen the film when you did the song and everything?
We'd seen a rough cut of it without any of the background music, and we loved it. We thought it was really funny. It's good to see the kind of English laughing at themselves, you know, that kind of upper crust thing. So we found it really funny. And then what really happened is the song actually caught our imagination as well, this naive little song. And for us to get involved with a movie, you know, it was quite special. Our careers always kind of went in one step at a time, and that was just another door that opened up. Someone said, we'd like to be involved with a film.
Great. Guys, we hope this up. We're going to have to stop, which is a great shame because we could have talked all morning. Thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you.
Give our love to Glasgow.
Yep.
See ya.
Take care of that hair.
We're back tomorrow with the...